everybody, this is Havoc, and welcome back to Terminus Total War. This is the overhaul mod for Total War Attila, which is basically an alternate history of Total War Attila. For those of you who don't know, many of you have asked for me to play as the Jewish Horde, so we're going to see just how good it is. Again, much like the Achaean Rebellion, if you do enjoy this and you want to see more, be 100 likes. We'll do that. We'll keep that kind of the new faction kind of deal, because I think we could break it. And if we don't, then clearly you guys don't have enough interest in it, and it wouldn't be worth me doing it. Anyways, so again, Judea. Their religion is Judaism, of course. Cultural trait is the Desert Kingdoms. They get Sun Scorch, which is +2 to sanitation in all regions once we settle. Attrition, we are immune to desert attrition. Scourge of the Desert, we get +15 melee attack during desert battles. And we have Fractured Face, which is the only negative one. Increased public order penalty for religious differences between new religions, which is faction-wide. Our faction traits, Yahweh's Chosen, for God is for us, who can stand against us? We get the Fury of our Maker's Hand, +10 unit morale when fighting against armies of other religions. That's pretty crucial. Rapacious Horde, food obtained only through settlement battles when the Horde. Okay, that's a little interesting kind of a setup. And then income, 5% interest on treasury at the end of the turn. That's really kind of cool. All right, guys, so we start as Jewish Horde outside of Palestinia. And initial challenge hard. Initial challenge is going to be legendary. We'll see just how legendary it truly is. I'm glad you guys are enjoying this content. I'm really liking this mod. It kind of brings a new flavor to the whole system and basically is a really, really good way to burn some time. I'm not saying that this isn't worth it on its own, but just a good way to burn some time until the Ancient Empires campaign. Oh, didn't mean to press that. All right, so here we are. We start. We are at war with the theme of Palestine. We only know the Ghassanids, and we only know the theme of Palestine. We are improving with these guys. Can we do a non-aggression pack? Nope. Okay, that's good. Awesome. Let's research some tech. If we get Cataphractoi, we get training grounds, cav corral, levy camp, and militia quarters. If we go here, enables the building of a village and a city. We're going to go there first. This is our army. We start with the Scions of Solomon. Jaber is our general. We have some Israelite warriors, excellent armor, average missile blocks, poor armor-piercing damage, basically like Jewish versions of the Cohors, or is it the Palatina? I don't quite remember. We have Israelite militia. These are tier 1 light militia. Not going to do a whole lot of damage, to be completely honest. We have some desert bowmen, some desert hurlers, and a bunch of desert raiders. Can we recruit anyone else? We cannot. We can recruit some desert tribesmen and some desert hurlers, and from the looks of it, Ayla is wide open, and that seems like the natural course to go, so let's go ahead and head that direction. We're going to auto-resolve, do a balanced. We lost 113, which is a little more than I was expecting. And then here, if we sack it, I don't think we get our food. It's a little iffy. It's a little weird.
We fight for you, my lord.
It's a little weird. I'm not gonna lie. But we did reduce their ability to do stuff. Now, the theme of Egypt, the theme of Palestine is strength ranking 43. We're strength ranking 54. Theme of Egypt is strength ranking 9. So we're really not gonna want to do anything to them. Now, our best bet would be basically, since we leveled up, let's get public order, which doesn't really matter for us right now, but then command in chief gives command movement range, which is pretty cool. And then I think we could probably encamp. And here are our tents, tribal tents. Tax rate -5%. We got recruitment tents. We got a gathering place, which we can bump up. Traveling artisans give us some, a little bit of, not integrity, they actually take away integrity, gives us a little boost to our economy. And then we have an open spot, which can be for an armament dump, which gives us +5 armor, shield effectiveness, melee weapon damage, or we can do a leader's tents, which gives us integrity, reduces food consumption, actually increases food consumption, and then wealth from culture. But our integrity goes up with this, so I think that would be a good one to go after. And then we could do leader's tents, but we really need something that can make us some food. Do we not have that ability? Do I not have a fields? Or was that a fields? No, it surely wasn't. farming fields. I guess we, but surely we could at least do, I don't know. Do they have a horde status? I think this is it. Okay, it is. So I guess we don't consume food. I'm not real sure on that one, to be honest. A scribe's tent, integrity -3. Wealth would be really good since we're getting +7 integrity. I wouldn't mind knocking down integrity a little bit if it gives us, a loot exchange. Sacking, looting, and raising +30%. Integrity -5. Wealth +500, and we can recruit onagers. I like that idea. Let's go ahead and end the turn. Let's see if the theme of Palestine comes after us. I don't really know. I'm assuming that's probably the only army they have, considering their strength ranking 46. That would make the most sense to me. All right, cool. It's not very nice. Maybe we could go up to Nova Trajana Bostra. Work some things out there. I don't necessarily want to settle right away. Mission issued. Own 9 regions to form a kingdom. We get a whole bunch of boosts if we do it. Should I get some tribesmen? They're better than these guys. I guess not. Well, yeah. Melee defense. Higher armor. More health. More morale. Speed's not as good. Melee attack isn't as either, but I think it'd still be good. Let's go ahead and get a couple of these guys. And then what do we got going in our camp? 2 more turns to get that. 1 more turn to get those. That's fine. We can't move because we're doing that recruitment, which is okay. Let's see what we can't get done. I don't really think I want to raise this area. This is definitely where we want to settle, and you got to remember, we have +15 melee attack anytime we fight a desert battle, which is super crucial. Here comes the theme of Palestine. Alright, and it looks like they have a whole bunch of awesome Roman units that we probably couldn't win against, so we're going to retreat. And hope that they can't follow me. Nope, they sure can't. Yeah, we'll definitely need some help fighting those guys. Imperium has increased. Political gain. Block the promotion. I did not issue that. My lord. And then we are just going to encamp here. Continue. Cotton weaver. Morale training +10. That's pretty crucial.
Our lord needs good fighters.
There we go. Let's see. Noble estate, we don't need that. Let's go ahead and do the cataphractoid. Actually, let's go ahead and get out of the range of these guys.
March. We fight for you, my lord.
Let's get right to here. And camp up. Boom, 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 boom. Boom. Let's go ahead and end the turn. And we should get a pretty good increase to our economy as well as an increase in our integrity. We'll go back to Ayla. Or I may even go down south and start wrecking the theme of Egypt. Or whatever it's called. Or they might just come after me. I didn't think they could reach that far. Goodness gracious, they are relentless.
Fall back! Finding shelter.
And I still can't recruit any mercenaries, can I? Faction destroyed the Gassanids.
At your command.
They are relentless. Now, okay, so they shouldn't be able to get right here. So I'm going to post up right here. And I'm going to do this again. I don't need mercenary desert heavy spears. Actually, I could use them. Go ahead and use them. Now, they shouldn't be able to reach. If they do, it's a load of BS. It might be a bug. Never know. All I want to do is recruit some more soldiers so I can take them on. That's it. If I can get past that army, The theme of Palestine is mine. See, look, he shouldn't be able to reach that. Dadgummit. And he just keeps getting more and more men, it seems like.
Retreat, man, retreat!
Oh, good lord, he's caught me. Okay. We're going to fight this on the battlefield then. Now, I do have superior cav, and I will have to use that to my advantage as much as possible. Yeah, I have 5 cav. They only have 2. And I can take out their archers. What's going to be tricksy is trying to hold them with my very not highly ranked men. It's just a load of BS. They shouldn't be able to reach me. Let's go hide up here. I have shield wall with those guys. I even have shield wall with these guys, even though I don't know how effective that's going to be. We got archers, which I'll place back here when the time comes. Where are you? You're just light. All these are light skirmishers? Okay. These are light melee. Which I'm going to pepper with. All is well and good, and our general's on horseback as well, which is awesome. Move, men. Their speed has got to be ridiculous. Their speed is 100. Awesome. There are some ponies. What is this? Oh, they all have scare. Oh, that's really cool. Alright, our guys are moving in over there. Trying to discover some troops. There's some troops. There's all their troops. Hello, chums. And they are running, so we're going to tire them out. Scare them. We're gonna scare them again. Make their morale drop pretty quick. There we go. Make them route for good. Losing quite a few in this little battle, this little exchange. Let's go ahead and pull out. It's a nice little skirmish. We're going to come out here on the flanks. Get back. Now these guys are moving slow. I'm going to use heavy shot with these men. I'm going to lead them on a nice little chase. Pew pew them. Pew pew them. Hit them. Throw things at them. Yes, yes, split your troops up. Your plan's working perfectly. Your plan, my plan's working perfectly. Start working on the cohorts. Both of you are in skirmish mode. There we go, route. Route, my friends. Kill him. How are we doing over here? There we go, boys. There we go. These guys are going to be pretty tired, but that's okay. Let's move these dudes up. Shield wall. Let's move up here. If they fall back behind that line, then we'll be able to do really good stuff there. I'm going to go ahead and put these guys out front, too. I'm going to wait till these troops are in melee. Before I hit them. What is this? Unbreakable. Oh, that's nice. That's a nice trait to have. Yeah, they realize they're kind of screwed. This is saying we can take these guys on. I'm going to see how true that is. No, let's get you off of that. Are they doing good? Oh, wow, they are. They are ripping them to shreds. Hit those guys in the back. Hit these guys. Take advantage. Morale debuff. Switch up to here. Hit these guys in morale debuff. Well, they can try. Actually, they are. They're doing it quite well, actually. Let's move up. Actually, let's round those guys. Sweet! We are routing those troops. Holy crap. How? Troops get out there. Troops get out of there. We're routing those cohorts. What in the world, man? These are some insanely awesome troops. Shoot those guys. You guys go after the general. Holy crap. Had I known they were this good, I would have... Well, no, I probably couldn't have taken them on before. You guys get out of that formation. What we need is we need more infantry on this side. Move up. Hit those guys in the back. Hit those guys in the back. You guys can come over here. And we caught those archers. One horseman, one melee horse for each of those guys. And we just swamped them. That's fine. Shoot at the general. Hit those guys in the back. It's a little bit of a conglomerated mess here. But that's okay. If we can catch the general... We done good. If I can just catch this unit and then I can hit him in the back with this guy. Oh yeah, this is going amazing. I mean, we're losing a decent amount of troops, but all things considered, we just took on a Roman army and mutilated them. Hit those guys in the back. Look at all of them. Oh man, we got this. Holy crap. Those guys are really good. Don't underestimate the Jews, apparently. That's what we're learning today. Go ahead and take them on. The battle is turning in our favor. Indeed it is. There you go, swarm on those guys. Very nice. We're going to super fast forward time, take out some troops. Go after them. You guys go here. It's worth it. It's worth every penny. So we only lost a good, not even, I mean, right at 500 soldiers. It's really, really not bad. Won the battle. Decisive victory indeed. That was intense. Yeah, 489 soldiers lost. That's, oh, look at that. I mean, those dudes are really, really good. That's right, dude. Like, you're dead. You're completely dead. I will take your reinforcements. Ready for orders. And that is completely surprising. I thought we were pretty much done. The cost of war, war awareness information, enemy killed. This dude, oh, that's right, we can level up these guys. Integrity when in foreign territory. Definitely. Upkeep costs minus 4% for land units or recruitment costs. Or integrity when known and allied. We're going to do that. Gives us 150. We are going to move halfway. And I'm going to encamp up because we desperately need that. And then we're going to go here. Unlocks desert spears. Replaces the desert levy. That's fine. And I don't really need a leader's tent right now. Our integrity is plus 8, though, just as an FYI. That date dryer is really helpful. Ooh, but we need food. But we get camel lancers, camel warriors, and desert bowmen. Yeah, I don't really want to mess with food right now, so we'll go ahead and just hit the intern. So, FYI... The Jews are really, really good. So we're going to take Aelia Capitolina, and I think we'll actually go ahead and settle. Oh, crap. They're just taking over everything. We're going to have to go to war with them because we need Nova Trajana Bostra. Judging by how our troops are, though, that's not a hard thing to do at all. Yeah, because they're going to take over everything, and I can't have that. Let's take a look at it. The Tanukids, they are rank 29. They're at war with just about everybody.
At your command.
They have desert pikes, Mavia's lancers.
We fight for you, my lord.
I don't really know that I want to mess with those. We can upgrade our troops. Oh, sick. Yes, that's awesome. Yep, because of that right there. That's really going to help us. Aelia Capitolina. I mean, we might as well go ahead.
Let them cower before our might.
Huh. They would last 9 turns. Let's go ahead and attack them ourselves, because we'll probably lose more if we auto-resolve. There's really not a whole lot of troops in there. And I can probably swarm over those towers, which is the main thing I'm concerned about. Swarm over those towers with our horsemen, which should have a fast capture perk to them. Fog, we're going to wait. Dry, that's what I like. Alright, yeah, there's going to definitely be some capture points. I've played this map before. I have indeed. Alright, sweet. Let's drop 3 units there. We're going to drop 4 there. I'm going to drop... Whoa. 3 units there, and my other 2 cav over here. We got our general. And then you guys can go straight up to this point. Let's go ahead and start the battle. See where they are. Move along. They've got a lot of their guys there, which is perfect. Let's go heavy shot. Hit those guys. Our slingers are going to go in there as well. Enemy reinforcements have indeed arrived. No worries. They got cav there. That should be pretty easily taken over.
The enemy tremble before our superior numbers.
Israelite militia, I'm really impressed with you. Israelite warriors, they look really cool, by the way. I mean, they have maces and stuff. It's basically Romans. I mean, that's what it is. A lot of these rebellions and uprisings and stuff, it's just Romans. But have risen up in rebellion against their Roman people. You know what I mean? Trying to seek their heritage yet again. They're retreating, which is perfect. We should be able to take this pretty quick. They should have a fast capture trait. Or is that these guys? Excellent capture power, that's what it is. So we're about to wreck that. Perfect. It would be unwise, or it'd be smart if you would turn around, because I can just retreat. Bye-bye. Or don't. There we go. Now you have those guys to worry about. And I'm going to hit you in the back. It would suck to beat these Romans right now. Here we go. Let's get some up close and personal action. Oh, nice beheading. Slaughter the Romans. Slaughter them. Let's move in. Take out that dude. Then we need to take out that tower as well. Those guys are wrecked. Let's go ahead and move here. We're going to move through them. You guys, move through, please. I'm really surprised these guys aren't losing a little more decisively. Which one of you has the perk? Getting hit from behind would not be pleasant, even if you are spearmen up against horsemen. They are now losing very decisively. Ponies are routing. There we go. Let's go ahead and move up. You two. Come up here and start peppering.
We are at your command. The enemy's tower has been destroyed.
Palatina guards. Let's move. Let's give you a little bit of a morale debuff. Give you a little bit of a morale debuff. Get those guys into the battle. Let's get our general up in here. That guy's routed. Awesome. Get back here. Nope. No, 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 no. Actually, shield wall it up. Get out, get out. guys, like, get back and get in shield wall, please. Shield wall, boys. Go ahead and get past them. See if that's possible. See if we can't just move past them and then hit them from behind. You know, kind of overwhelm them. Is that not going to work? ...15 seconds and those guys get a debuff. They're losing pretty quickly. We've still lost quite a few men. It probably actually would have been better if we wouldn't have done an auto resolve, but that's okay. And morale debuff. Oh, his morale's at 16. Push through. Push through. Diamond. Come on. Turn around. Charge right into him. It's a cheap move, but I don't care. There we go. These guys are losing decisively, so we'll stop. Any of my other troops have some cool abilities like that? There we go. Maybe we can get a proper charge on them. There we go, in the battle. Whew, that was a little scary. We lost 470, which is a little unfortunate, but we are going to go ahead and settle, I think. Or we could run around, I don't know. You know, it is the end of the episode, guys, so I'm going to let you decide. Should we run around and be a horde? Or should we take this on and settle here? I don't really know. So I'm going to let you guys decide that. Actually, you know, I have to decide here. I can't escape until I decide something, which is a little unfortunate, but that's okay. We will no longer be a migrating party. Kind of like the idea of being a migrating party for a little bit. Yeah, let's just go ahead and sack it. Ready for battle. All right, guys. Well, it is up to you on what we get to do next. Yeah, that'll be good. So we are going to rest up for a little bit. And we need to decide what we want to do. So if you want me to be a horde, let me know in the comment section down below. If you want me to settle Aelia Capitolina, or we should go over to Nova Trajana Bostra and go to war with the Tanukids, then let me know. Regardless, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little preview of the Judean Horde. They are a pretty powerful faction. They're much more powerful than I thought they would be originally. So that says a lot. And that really does say a lot. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Haven't already hit that subscribe button. Remember, 100 likes, 100 thumbs up buttons will get us to the next episode. If you haven't already, follow me on Twitch, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Be on the lookout for the next episode of the Judean Horde. This is Havoc, and I'm out of here. Peace!